Hello, good morning students. We will see the details of unique constraint now. Unique constraint is similar to a primary key. It also does not support duplicate values. So in order to avoid duplicate values, we can use unique constraint. Actually, only one field in a table can be primary key, but multiple fields can have unique constraints. Unique also describes that the values entered in unique fields should be unique, should not contain duplicates. Okay, so here also the usage is similar. We will see the first syntax. Create table student, class number, if it is primary key, we can give primary key, class number primary key, comma, name, character, ten size, comma, I am giving phone number, space, int, space, unique. Okay, so this indicates that there is a field called phone number, which is of integer type, and it is a unique type. It means it does not, it will not accept duplicates in the field. Okay, so we can use it like this. We'll try to execute it. What happened? Class number, okay, we have not given the type. So class number int primary key. Okay. So query is okay. Describe student. Okay, it is showing like this. Class number type is integer. Key primary, null no. It means that a primary key field cannot have null values. Okay, but a unique field can have null values. So it's a difference between unique and a primary key. A primary key does not support null values, while unique fields can have null values. Okay, so I am dropping this again. Drop student. So removing the table set. Drop table student. Removing the table structure student. Okay. Now the second syntax is the other one. So this is column constraint. Column level constraint. Okay, we can have table level constraint like we have seen in primary key. So create table student, class number primary key, comma, name, character 10, comma, phone number int. Then I am giving comma here. Now I am using to define the unique constraint. So unique, which one is unique? Class, which one is unique? Phone number is unique. Okay, so this is column level constraint. That is after defining all the fields, we will put a comma and then give unique phone number. If two or three fields are unique type, then we can put comma and can give the field name here. So Now name and phone number will be unique values. We'll be accepting unique values only. So if you want to have only one field as unique, we can give the field name there. If you want more fields as unique, we can give the field names by putting commas in between them. Okay. So here you can see that class number is primary key, and we are making phone number and name as unique fields. You try to execute this. Class number primary key. Okay, again we don't have given that type class number int primary key. Had it typed there, class number int primary key, and so this is the query. So it works. It means that create table class number int primary key, name character 10, phone number we have defined, and after all the fields I have put a comma and have given the unique constraint, and in brackets I have mentioned about the field names in which the phone number and in which the value should be unique. So here the phone number and name will be unique. So describe student. Okay. Now we will see the other syntax. So this phone number and name combinedly, it works as unique. This is the property, that's why we have seen the multiple value there. That is, if I give one field name, then we need to give unique values in that field name. But if I give phone number comma name, then the combination should be unique. The combination means no two fields should have same values in phone number and name. It accepts phone number again, but phone number and name combinedly, it should be a unique value. That is the meaning of this multiple fields given in brackets. That is why it is shown as mul. Okay. So if I want to have only phone number as unique, then we can give unique phone number. Now we'll drop that table. Okay. Now the third syntax is again the same thing. So this is a table level constraint. Okay. And here we can give a name for the constraint also. So I have to give the keyword constraint. Constraint. What is the name? T2, unique phone number. Okay, this is the third syntax where we are giving a name for the constraint. Okay, so this is how we have created a name for the constraint also. Describe student. So it is unique. Phone number is unique. And this is how we create unique fields. Okay. This is the usage of unique query, unique constraint. Okay, we'll see the next constraint in the next class. Okay, hope that you got the point. We have three types of syntax for setting unique constraints also: column level, table level, and table level with a name for the constraint. Okay.